breaded seafood in your iCombi Pro. Doing breaded seafood in your iCombi Pro is a very easy task. There's many different types of breadings. You could use a traditional breading. You could use panko. And today, we're going to do a cornmeal crusted cod. So I'm going to go ahead first and preheat my iCombi Pro. First, I go over to the home screen, and I select the seafood cooking mode. All of my cooking paths come up, and I'm going to choose breaded. Now, we're using kind of a flat piece of cod, so I'm going to go without the probe. If you have a piece that's 3/4 inch thick or greater, you can choose to work with the probe simply by selecting with the probe. So we're going to choose without the probe, and I'm going to choose my browning level 2. All right. So while that's preheating, we're going to go ahead and prepare our product. All right, so here we have our granite enamel pan, 3/4 inch granite enamel pan. We're going to spray it down with a little bit of pan release. The reason why I'm selecting the granite enamel pan is because it evenly distributes the heat and it contributes to a nice golden brown result. All right. So the process is very simple. What we're going to do is we're going to take our breaded cod and we're going to dip it in a little bit of canola oil. You could use grapeseed oil. You could use olive oil. The key here is to use an oil of your choice in smaller quantities. So we take our corn-crusted cod, dip one side into the oil, and place it with the dip side up, facing up, onto the pan. I'm going to repeat that action for all the other pieces that I have here. And as you can see, we're using a lot less oil. I do not have to dip both sides of the cod. One side is sufficient to get a nice crispy result without using too much oil. All right. So the iCombi Pro is letting me know that it's time to load. So we're going to open the door. We place in our breaded cod and shut the door. It's automatically going to begin cooking for us. So as you can see here on the screen, the process begins in a combi mode. It's going to determine the load size that we put in. This way, if we're doing one tray, or if we're doing 6 trays, when we're using the intelligent cooking suite, it'll automatically adapt to the changes in the volume. Afterwards, it's going to automatically switch to a dry climate. So it'll maintain the moisture in the beginning and then pull out humidity just in the right moment in order to deliver the crispy crust. All right, so we're in the middle of cooking our corn-crusted cod, and the unit has automatically transitioned into dry heat. If I look at my settings, my previous step was in combi. So now when we're in dry heat, you can kind of see inside the cooking cabinet that the browning is beginning to take place. So due to the new iCooking suite operating system, chef intervention is possible. So if I make a decision and I decide, you know what, I need to lighten up the browning level because it's getting a little bit too dark, or I need to darken up the browning level because it's not dark enough for my liking, I can still intervene in this step. The chef intervention is really helpful because you can change the internal core temperature if you need to, if you're cooking with the core temperature probe, and you can also adjust the coloration or the cooking time if you're working with a manual time input. Our iCombi Pro is telling us that our breaded fish is done. So we're going to open the door, grab some towels. Wow. Look at that. I just want to show you a couple options here. It cooked in about 8 minutes and 4 seconds. It's ready, but if I wanted to add time, I could easily select one of my end steps here, the picture of the clock. I press that, and it allows me to add time. It pops up with a timer for 3 minutes. I can adjust that down, or I can adjust it up, just like this. All right. I can also save it the way I have it here. So if I'm all set, I can hit Save As. I can type in corn crusted cod. And hit the check mark. All right. It says corn crusted cod saved successfully. All right. If I want to put a new batch in, I could also simply press New Batch, and then I don't have to wait for the preheat. I can just load. So where do I go to find my corn-crusted cod? Let's say we're all set. I back out, hold it down, the back button for 3 seconds. I go to Programs, and I look at my Chef Hat Intelligent Cooking Suite Programs, and it comes up right here, corn-crusted cod. I can make it a favorite by hitting the 3 dots, or I can press corn-crusted cod, and it will begin a new batch of corn-crusted cod with the name that I saved up on top. Let's have a look at what we have here and our final results. All right. So it's a nice golden brown finish. Let's have a look at this, both sides. Look at that, beautiful golden brown. All right, okay. Let's go ahead and plate one up. And I know you guys are gonna be eager to try this as soon as possible. Put a bit of little lemon, little lime. Let's squeeze one right here. The inside, as you can see, it's a beautiful, beautiful moist. The steam is coming right out of it. But on the outside, you have a nice, crispy, crunchy crust. Mmm, so good.